Cooking in the Kitchen at Olum's with registered dietitian Molly Morgan, Olum's cooking consultant.
Today we're making mini meatloaf, so now you don't have to fight over the meatloaf at your house. Yes. You can just get your own personal meatloaf.
And everybody gets a crispy part. That's one of the fun things about
Definitely.
Making it this way. So I've got 1 pound of grass-fed ground beef. And I have to tell you, there is a nutrition benefit, mm-hmm. and it does cost a little bit more, but you can see it's very lean, 93% lean, mm-hmm. and it is full. The fat that is in there is healthier fat for you.
Right.
So it definitely is worth paying the extra. And it's 1 pound I've got there.
Okay.
Now we've got to add veggies.
Yes.
So veggies are a key filler.
Sure.
And we've got a half cup of diced onion, a half cup of grated or shredded carrots.
I've never thought of putting carrots in meatloaf, but definitely onions are an essential part, so.
You know what I love about adding lots of veggies is beef in general, of course, has quite a few calories, mm-hmm. and by adding veggies, it helps stretch those calories out throughout our portions. Mm-hmm. And I'm always, you know, trying to sneak in extra veggies.
helping it up with Molly.
And I've got a quarter cup of whole wheat panko breadcrumbs.
Okay. Do you want me to just keep mixing?
Yep, you can just keep mixing.
All right.
I've got 3 tablespoons of one of kind of my secret weapons, if you will. It's ground flaxseed.
Wow.
And add some omega-3 fats, but it also is going to help our meatloaf stick together because you'll notice we're not adding any egg to this.
Yes, yes.
And that often is added. This is the liquid we're going to add for flavor. It's a quarter cup of lager.
Wow.
That was beer we just added.
Right.
Isn't that fun? But it adds a nice flavor to the meatloaf.
Mm-hmm.
And then a quarter cup of your favorite
barbecue sauce.
And I'm actually going to include a recipe with this for my favorite barbecue sauce, which we've made before. It's a maple barbecue sauce.
Ooh.
So you can grab that recipe when you get this.
Yeah, it smells so good too.
And you can bring that over
sure.
while I finish mixing this. How about that?
And you actually sprayed this too.
Yes. You want to prepare your muffin tins with nonstick cooking spray. It'll just make getting your little mini meatloafs out of the tin easier.
So much easier.
And cleanup easier.
Yeah.
Now we're going to fill these, and about 2 tablespoons of the mixture per muffin tin is perfect. And they don't raise like when you make cupcakes, but the 2 tablespoons should fill them nicely and make great little size of your meatloafs. And then 2 of these is considered a serving. So it serves 6 if you split 2 up. And if you get a little light at the end, you can kind of just pinch from the other ones if some of them got full. Okay. Now let's use up all this. Perfect. And then what you do is your fingers get a little messy here, but just kind of pack it in.
Okay.
And that'll help make sure when we bring them out of the oven after baking, they come out nice and clean.
All right.
And easily. Now they're ready to head to the oven, and they're going to bake at 350 degrees for 20 to 25 minutes. And I've got some finished ones here. You can see how great these little mini meatloaves turn out.
Yeah, they do.
Perfect for dinner, and you can freeze them. So
perfect.
Great to make ahead. For this mini meatloaf recipe, visit olums.com. Enjoy the day.
Cooking in the Kitchen was brought to you from the fully operational Thermidor Kitchen at Olum's.